Hello dear students, myself Assistant Professor Santosh Napte, Department of Microbiology, Sambhajirao Kendriya Mahavidyalaya, Jalakot. So friends, today we will see about the basics of genetics. So in this today's lecture, we will see about this inheritance and variations. So what is meant by inheritance? Inheritance means it is the transmission of characters from one generation to next generation. All of you know that whatever that characters are present in our parents, that characters are also present in our body. That is nothing but these characters, they get transmitted from our parents to us. So that is called as inheritance, and variations are nothing but the differences among the progenies or offsprings of the same parents. Because we also observe that here, whatever that characters present in one offsprings of parents, there are some differences in the offsprings of the same parents. So these differences among the children of the same parents, these are called as variations. So here we will see two subunits. The first one is chromosomes and mechanism of inheritance, and second one is genetic terminology. Because genetics, it is actually a separate branch of biology and which deals with the study of heredity and variations, or inheritance and variations. And here, so that's why we are going to see separately, that is chromosomes and mechanism of this inheritance or heredity, and later on we will see about the basic terms or concepts of this genetics, that is under the heading genetic terminology. So the first one is chromosomes and mechanism of inheritance. So what are these chromosomes? So chromosomes are thread-like structures of nucleic acids, that is DNA and protein, which is located inside the nucleus of plant and animal cells, and they carries the genetic information in the form of genes. So these are chromosomes, which are nothing but the thread-like structures, and these thread-like structures, these are made up of DNA and protein, which are present inside the nucleus of plant as well as animal cells, and they carries the genetic information which is present in the form of genes. See, this is the diagram here in which that shows the double stranded DNA molecule here, and this double stranded DNA molecule which consists of these base pairs, and later on this double stranded DNA molecule having these histone proteins and nucleosomes, it get coiled and supercoiled to form the thread-like structures which are called as chromosomes. So these are the thread-like structures which are called as chromosomes, and these thread-like structures, chromosomes, these are present inside the nucleus of a particular cell. So this is the definition of chromosome. Now the next point is, what is inheritance? As I told earlier here, the transmission of genetic information from generation to generation, or from one generation to next generation, it is called as heredity, or it is known as inheritance. Or the another definition is transmission of characters from one generation to next generation, it is called as heredity. So jo bhi characters ek generation se agle generation mein transfer hote hai, ye jo mechanism hai, this is called as heredity, or it is known as inheritance. Chahe kaun se bhi living things aap consider karo, that may be human being, that may be plant, that may be animals, that may be that small creatures or microorganisms. So whatever that characters are present in one generation, that same characters, they get transmitted to next generation. So this mechanism or this process of transmission of these characters or of this genetic information from one generation to next generation, that is called as heredity, or it is known as inheritance. See, this is the diagram here that explains what is meant by heredity. So all of you know that, or there is a question is in your mind maybe, why do children looks like their parents? जो भी चिल्ड्रन से उनके पेरेंट्स की तरह ही दिखते हैं. और व्हाई डू ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर्स दे रिसेम्बल्स ईच अदर, ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर वो भी सिमिलर दिखते हैं, सेम दिखते हैं. सो द रीजन बिहाइंड दिस इज दे इनहेरिट दैट ट्रेट्स और दैट कैरेक्टर्स फ्रॉम देयर पेरेंट्स, एंड द पासिंग ऑफ दिस कैरेक्टर्स और ट्रेट्स फ्रॉम पेरेंट्स टू चाइल्ड और चिल्ड्रेंस, इट इज द बेसिस ऑफ हेरिडिटी. सो दिस इज this diagram, it explains what is meant by heredity. So the Gregor John Mendel, which born in 1822, he first gave the accurate explanation for the mechanism of this inheritance by carrying out hybridization experiments or by using hybridization technique. So Gregor John Mendel was the first scientist who perform many experiment, and he accurately gives the explanation for this mechanism of transmission of characters from one generation to next generation. And whatever that experiments, whatever that test or technique he used to explain this mechanism, that techniques are called as hybridization techniques. So these are known as hybridization technique. So the next slide is for his hybridization experiment that Mendel selected pea plant. The scientific name of that pea plant is Pisum sativum. So this Gregor John Mendel, he selected pea plant for his experiment, and he considered 7 characters to perform this hybridization experiment. So whatever that experiment was conducted by Gregor John Mendel, all these experiments, these are conducted on this pea plant, and the scientific name of that pea plant is Pisum sativum. And the characters which was considered by Mendel, that characters considered, that was 7 characters of that pea plant, or the 7 traits of that pea plants. So Mendel studied inheritance of these 7 characters individually, that is by considering one character at a time, or later on he consider 2 or 3 characters at a time. So in this way, Mendel performed his experiment or hybridization experiment on pea plant by considering, or by considering 7 characters or traits of that pea plant. But whatever that study was carried out by Mendel, just he carried out experiments by considering 1 character at a time, or sometimes 2 characters at a time, or 3 characters at a time. Then later on, so this next point or next slide is here. See, these are the 7 pairs of contrasting visible characters in pea plant which was considered by Mendel for his hybridization technique. So as I told earlier, the scientific name of that pea plant is Pisum sativum. Now see, these are the dominant characters and the recessive characters. So these seed shape, then seed color, pod shape, pod color, then flower color, flower location, and height of the plant. These are the 7 characters which was considered by Mendel. And each of these characters, they have 2 different forms. One is the dominant form and another one is the recessive form. So here that we will see first that dominant characters. So round seed shape, it is the dominant character, and this wrinkled seed shape, it is the recessive character. So these 2, round seed shape and that wrinkled seed shape, these are the 2 different forms of this seed shape of that pea plant. Then second character which was considered by Mendel for his hybridization technique, it is seed color. So this seed color, it is yellow seed color, and later on, or which is a dominant character, and the recessiveness of this seed color, it is nothing but the green seed color. So these are the 2 characters or 2 different forms of this seed color. Third character which was considered by Mendel is pod shape. The dominant pod shape, it is nothing but inflated, and the recessive pod shape, it is nothing but the constricted. See, just see the difference between these 2 forms by observing this diagram here. Then fourth character which was considered by Mendel is pod color, One is green pod color, that is the dominant character, and second one is yellow pod color, which is the recessive character. Next character which was considered by Mendel is flower color. One is purple flower, which is dominant character, and second one is white flower color, which is recessive character. Then sixth character which was considered for his hybridization experiment is flower location. One is the axial flower location, and second one is the terminal flower location. And the last character which was considered by Gregor John Mendel for his experiment is plant height. That is dominant form of this plant height, it is nothing but the tall plant, and second one is here short or dwarf plant. So these are the seven characters considered by Mendel, which has the two different forms. One is dominant form and second one is the recessive form. So the next point is here, next slide is, so whatever that experiment was conducted by Gregor John Mendel, and during his experiment he observed that characters or that traits, these are not inherited physically, but there is something is present in the gametic cells of that plants, which Mendel called as a factors, and he observed that factors are actually responsible for the transmission and expression of a particular character or that trait in these pea plants. So today we all of you know that these characters or that factors which are called by Mendel, these are nothing but the genes. So today that Mendelian factors are nothing but, these are called as the genes. And these factors which are occur in pairs in the parents, and during gamete formation they get segregated from each other without blending or without mixing of that cells or that characters. See, these are the next slide. So Mendel gets succeeded in his all experiments, and there are some reasons behind the success of Gregor John Mendel, which carried out that experiments, and the reasons for that Mendel success. The first reason is he carefully planned and involved large samples. Second reason is Gregor John Mendel carefully recorded the number of plants of each type and expressed results in ratios. Third reason behind the success is he selected pea plant in which contrasting characters can be easily recognized. Then fourth reason is the seven different characters in pea plant were controlled by a single factor each. And the next reason for the Mendelian success is the factors, these are located on separate chromosomes, and these factors are transmitted from one generation to next generation. So all of these are the reasons behind the success of Mendel's in his hybridization technique or that experiments. So that is about what we have explained up to date or up to this time. That was the basics of genetics and that Mendelian experiments. See, the next point we will see here, that is about genetic terminology. So there are different terms are there or concepts are there that must be understood to see. So that one by one we are going to see here. The first one is character. So it is a specific feature of an organism. For example, height of stem, then flower color, flower location, pod color or pod shape. If we are considering the organism, that is nothing but plant for example, so the character of this pea plant are nothing but the height of stem, flower color, flower location, pod color or pod shape. Then second concept is, that is trait. So an inherited character and its detectable variant. For example, here trait means it is an inherited character, that is which get transmitted from one generation to next generation, and its detectable variant. If we will take the example of height of the plant here, so this height of plant, it is an inherited character from one generation to next generation, and that height, it is present in two different forms. One is tallness and the second one is dwarfness. So these two are the detectable variants of this character or of this trait. The second example is here, purple or white flower color. So the second character or the second inherited character, it is nothing but the flower color, and these two are the detectable variants of this flower color, that is nothing but purple flower color and white flower color. The next one is position of the flower. This is the third inheritable character or trait, and these two are the detectable variants, that is axial position of the flower and terminal position of the flower. Next one is, that is color of the pod. So this green color and yellow color, these are the two detectable variants of the this pod color of the that pea plant. And the next character or trait which get inherited, it is nothing but pod shape. And the two detectable variants of this pod shape, these are inflated pod shape and the second one is constructed pod shape. So this is called as the trait. Then third character is factor, or third definition or concept, it is nothing but the factor. So it is a unit of heredity, or a particle present in the organism which is actually responsible for the inheritance and expression of a character. जो भी character यहाँ पे one generation से next generation में transmit होता है, so that character get transmitted, it is because of the particle present in the organism, and that particle, it is called as factor. The another definition of that factor is that factors which is passed from one generation to next through the gametes. Because whatever that factor responsible for the transmission and expression of character, it is present in the gametes of that parents. So that is known as factor, or the factor which determines a genetical or biological character of that particular organism. Because if that particular factor is present in the organism or in that gametes, so that determines the genetic as well as biological characters of the particular organism. So this is the definition of factors. Next one is gene. So today's gene, it is nothing but the Mendelian factor, and this gene, it is a particular segment of DNA molecule which is responsible for the inheritance and expression of that particular character. Matlab jo bhi character yahan pe transmit ho raha hai from one generation to next generation, that character is due to the gene, which is nothing but the segment of DNA molecule. See, this is the nucleus, that is cell, then this is nucleus. In that nucleus, that chromosomes are present here, and in that chromosomes there is a double stranded DNA molecule is present. So this small fragment, for example, from here to this one, this small fragment of this DNA molecule, it is called as gene. So this gene get transmitted from one generation to next generation, and it get expressed in the form of this protein. So this is called as gene. Next one is alleles or allelomorph. So these two or more alternative forms of a particular given gene or factor, these are called as alleles of each other, and they occupy identical position on the homologous chromosomes. तो alleles क्या है और allelomorphs क्या है? These are two or more alternative forms of a particular gene. एक particular gene के दो और उससे ज्यादा जो form, अलग अलग form होते हैं, alternative form होते हैं, उस alternative forms को हम बोलते हैं alleles, और these are called as allelomorphs. And they are present on the identical position on that particular homologous chromosomes. Another way for defining these alleles or allelomorphs is, these are nothing but the multiple forms of the same gene that occupy the same loci or position, and they give rise to different forms of the same character. So ye सेम कैरेक्टर के, जैसे एक अगर हमने कैरेक्टर कंसिडर किया हाइट ऑफ द प्लांट और उसके जो अलग अलग फॉर्म है वो है टॉलनेस एंड डॉर्फनेस. सो दिस इज बिकॉज ऑफ, सो व्हाट एवर द डिफरेंट फॉर्म्स ऑफ दैट टॉलनेस आर देयर, दैट हाइट इज देयर, दैट मे बी टॉलनेस और दैट मे बी डॉर्फनेस, इट इज बिकॉज ऑफ अलील्स और एलिलोमॉर्फ. सी दिस इज द डायग्राम हियर विच शोज द अलील और एलिलोमॉर्फ. सो दीज आर द टू होमोलॉगस क्रोमोसोम्स हियर और होमोलॉगस पेयर ऑफ क्रोमोसोम्स. This is allele for purple flower color and this is allele for white flower color. So on this both homologous chromosomes they are occupying the same position or location here, but they are responsible for the different forms of that particular trait or particular character. Next one is dominant allele. So it is an allele that expresses its trait even in the presence of an alternative allele. अभी हमने यहाँ पे डेफिनेशन देखी है कि allele are nothing but the alternative forms, और दोनों allele जब वहां पे प्रेजेंट रहते हैं लेकिन दोनों में से एक का जब एक्सप्रेशन होता है तो जिसका एक्सप्रेशन होता है उस allele को हम बोलते हैं डोमिनेंट allele. सो दिस alleles, डोमिनेंट allele इज दैट allele विच एक्सप्रेसेस इट्स कैरेक्टर और ट्रेट इवन इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ एन अल्टरनेटिव allele एंड दैट इज हेटेरोजाइगस कंडीशंस ओनली. Or the allele that expresses in F1, it is called as dominant. F1 means here that is first generation. So that is F1, or the dominant allele, it is an allele of a pair that masks the expression of the other allele in F1 generation. And it is denoted by capital letters. See this diagram again here. See, this is the phenotype and this is also a phenotype. So this allele is responsible for such type of coloration or phenotype here, character, and this allele, it is responsible for this one. So these two are the alleles. Both of these, the allele, they get combined in next generation, and but though there are both alleles are present here, but there is an expression of only one allele. So there is an expression of this allele. So that's why the allele which get expressed even in presence of the alternative allele. So this is the alternative allele here, and so that's why, so this is the alternative allele, but in presence of this alternative allele, this allele expressing themselves, so that's why this allele, it is called as dominant allele. See, this is the diagram, another funny diagram here. So this is dominant over this one. So though both are present here, but only one is expressing, so that's why it is a dominant. And here there is no expression of this second children here in presence of this one, so this is called as recessive allele. Next we will see the definition. See, these are the table which shows dominant and recessive alleles in that pea plant here. For example, organism pea plant and another examples are here. So this is the pea plant. The gene height, for example, dominant allele for that height is, that is tallness, and it is denoted by the symbol T. And the recessive allele for height is, that is dwarfness, that is small t. Then in case of human being, the gene which is responsible for brown eye color, it is a dominant allele which is denoted by B, capital B, and the recessive allele for that eye color, that is blue color, and it is denoted by small b. Next one is here Drosophila. The wing length, dominant character or allele is here long, and it is denoted by capital L. Then recessive allele, it is short, denoted by small l. Then next one is maize. The gene or the dominant character is here grain color, dominant allele, that is purple, denoted by capital P. Then recessive allele, yellow, denoted by small p. And in guinea pig, the coat color, it is black, which is a dominant character or dominant allele, and it is denoted by b. Then recessive allele, that is small b, which determines the character, that is white coat color. So these are the examples of dominant and recessive alleles. Next one is here recessive allele. So as I already told earlier here, which is not expressed in presence of an alternative allele, or that is in heterozygous condition, that allele is called as recessive allele. And it expresses only in the presence of another identical allele. Now we know that recessive allele it is indicated by small letter. So if there are two recessive alleles are present, at that time only that recessive alleles expresses themselves. Otherwise, if one is dominant, another one is recessive, then there is an expression of dominant allele but not recessive allele. And it is an allele that does not express in F1 hybrid, because in hybrid there is two alleles are present. For example, here one is dominant, another one is recessive. And if both types of alleles are present, then there is a suppression of recessive allele and there is an expression of dominant allele. So this recessive allele, it does not express in F1 hybrid or in F1 generation. See, this is the monohybrid cross for stem length. See, this P parentals, one is tall parent, second one is dwarf parent. That tall parent, they have both dominant alleles, and that dwarf parent, they have both recessive alleles. So the gametes which are formed here, one is dominant having dominant allele, another gamete that is from second parent having recessive allele. So both of these gametes, they combine in F1 generation and they are having this heterozygous condition, because both of these alleles are different. One is dominant, second one is recessive. And therefore, the plants which are all plants in F1 generation, these are tall plants. So there is a suppression of this dwarfness. So that's why this dwarfness, or the allele which is responsible for that dwarfness, that is small t, that is called as recessive allele. So this is the concept of this recessive allele. Next concept is phenotype. Phenotype means the external appearance of individual for any character or any trait. If you will take the example of height of a plant, so you can observe the height of a plant, whether it is tall or whether it is dwarf. So this height of a plant, that may be tallness, that may be dwarfness, you are observing, or this is the external appearance of that individual for that trait. So this type of external appearance of an individual for any particular trait, that is called as phenotype. And it is observable and determined by the different combinations of alleles. For example, in case of pea plant, for the height of that stem, that may be tall or it may be dwarf. And there are two phenotypes. That is, tallness, it is determined by these both dominant allele, or one dominant and one recessive allele. And dwarfness, it is determined by this both recessive alleles. So this is called as phenotype. See, these are the different types of phenotypes here, because all these can be observed, or that can be appeared externally. That may be tallness, that may be short height of that pea plant, which is a recessive trait. That tallness, it is dominant. Then a round seed shape, then yellow seed color, green seed coat color, then inflated pod shape, green pod color, or axial flower position. All these are dominant trait or dominant character. And then short height, wrinkled seed shape, green seed color, white seed coat color, then constricted pod shape, or yellow pod color, or terminal flower position. All these are the recessive traits of these pea plants. So these are the different phenotypes in pea plant. All these are called as phenotypes because we can observe externally, or they can appear externally. So that's why these are called as the phenotypes. Next one is genotype. अभी जो भी character आपको दिख रहा है, उस characters के लिए जो भी genes responsible है, उस characters के लिए जो भी alleles responsible है, so that genetic constitution, that genetic makeup of that particular organism with respect to any particular trait, that is called as genotype. जैसे हमने यहाँ पे देखा कि for example, see here, that tallness of that plant, this tallness, it is a phenotype because you can observe that, or that can be appear externally. But the genes or the alleles which are responsible for that tallness, that cannot be observed, that cannot be appear. So that this genetic makeup, this genetic constitution which is responsible for that tallness, it is called as genotype. So this is the definition of genotype. And it is a representation of the genetic constitution of that particular individual with respect to a single character, or with respect to a set of characters, that is many characters. Just I told that example here, that pea tall plants can have the genotype that both dominant alleles or one dominant and one recessive. So these capital T, capital T, or capital T, small t, these are the genotype for this tallness of the pea plant. And this small t, it is a genotype for this dwarfness of the pea plant. So this is called as genotype. So these are the genotypes here. Round seal shape, it is a dominant character, so that's why it is indicated as capital letter R. Then yellow seed color, capital Y. Then inflated pod shape, small capital I. Then green pod color, capital G. Then flower color, capital P here for purpleness. Then axial flower position, capital A. Then plant height for tallness, capital T. So all these characters are, that is round, yellow, inflated, green, purple, axial and tall, all these characters are dominant, and that's why they are indicated as capital letters. Opposite to that, that recessive characters and recessive alleles, these are indicated by small letters, same small letters, that is small r, small y, small I, then small g, then small p, small a and small t. That is, these are the recessive traits, wrinkledness, green, then constricted, yellow, white, then terminal and short. So these are the phenotypes and genotypes of dominant and recessive traits of the pea plant. Then next one is homozygous, or which is called as pure. So an individual possessing identical alleles for a particular trait, identical alleles are present here. So this is called as homozygous, or it is called as pure for that particular trait. For example, so this, and they produce only one type of gametes. Just take the example here, height of the plant, that is tall, and they have these dominant alleles, capital T, capital T. So these are pure. Or if you take the example of dwarfness of the that plant, there is a two alleles are present, recessive alleles, small t, and both of these plants, that tall plant and the dwarf plant, they produce only one type of gametes, that is capital T and small t respectively. So this is about the definition of homozygous or that pure.